one, I want to say thank you so much to Fernie for the introduction. Really appreciate it. And thank you so much to everybody here for having me here today. I know you guys might be thinking, what is Pitbull doing here today? I'm thinking the same thing. But speaking of that, they told me that Bill Cosby has spoken here before, which I think is amazing. Someone that I really relate to. I also love Jell-O, you know? I'm just getting started. Bill Gates, phenomenal, incredible. I relate to Bill Gates. We're both very good looking, you know? And Bill Clinton, you know I really relate to Bill Clinton. We're both musicians. But I'd like to say, as an artist, entertainer, entrepreneur, and a real student of life, it is a true, true, true honor to be here today. For one, we're gonna go into it. I had to actually write something. I said, wow, I'm so used to making records, and you know, to be up here speaking to you guys actually makes me nervous, so imagínate. That means imagine. So however, I want you to know one thing. I'm not just a charter school advocate. First and foremost, I am a charter school parent, okay? Every day I see firsthand, and this is the truth, it may sound a little written, but it's not, I promise you. Okay, this is everything that we put together. But every day I see firsthand how my children are becoming highly motivated, lifelong learners, thanks to the educators in the charter schools they attend. I am grateful to all of you for having made charter schools a reality. Now I'm gonna go off my own words, and I'm gonna tell you from the heart, I'm more than grateful. I'm gonna tell you why. Because I see how much these teachers really care about these kids. I see what these teachers mean to these kids, and I see the change in their life that they make. And I wish, sometimes I look at all the kids, not just mine, I look at them and I say, man, I wish that I would have been able to go to school and enjoy it like that. Thank you. So speaking of teachers, I had two teachers in my life that changed my life and kept me highly motivated. First one was actually, I would say there at a very special moment in my life where I ended up in a foster home in Georgia due to a lot of situations in my family at the time. And her name was Miss Ryan. She was one of my second grade teachers. I say one of mine because I had many of them. I've been to many schools. But she always, I don't know what she saw in me, but she would pick me up. She'd take me to the movies. If we didn't have Christmas, she made sure one way or another we'd make it feel like a Christmas. And she was one of those people that taught me that people really care. There's people out there that really want the best for you. That was my first experience with a great teacher. And I remember her to this day. My second experience would be with Hope Martinez. Hope Martinez was my 11th grade teacher at Coral Park Senior High School. And I would say was the first teacher to really believe in me and my talent. I didn't even know that I had at the time. She gave me an invitation to a DMX video shoot. DMX was a big artist, I would say about 98, and for me it was just an honor to go out there and be able to see him, you know? But when she handed me the invitation, she told me, let me tell you something. I don't want anything from you, but all I want from you is for you to say, thank you, Miss Martinez, when you win your first award at an award show. And that to me showed me how much she believed in me that I couldn't believe it at the time. Sure enough, we've thanked her at many of award shows. Okay. Gracias a Dios. And matter of fact, I'm gonna thank her here today. Thank you to Hope Martinez for believing in me and giving me the chance to be able to speak to everybody here today on how much we fight for and believe, I would say, in education. With that said, so to all the teachers in the room, thank you, thank you, thank you. The future of our children and our country depends on you. I, for one, have total faith in you. We all have total faith in you. You deserve freedom and respect and charter schools. The only reason that they're successful is because they respect great teachers and give them great freedom to teach. I love charter schools because they are fundamentally about freedom. And freedom is what America's all about. Like I say in one of my songs, freedom is what we fight for. Freedom is what we die for. In fact, this week we celebrate freedom. We fought to establish this great nation. My family fled Cuba in search of that freedom because families there were being denied of the freedom to decide where and how to educate their children. So this right here in America, we believe in freedom, and charter schools give parents the freedom to choose where and how to educate their children. That's something worth fighting for. That's something worth dying for. And that's why I've joined the fight. In my industry, they say, ride or die. In education, it should be educate or die. This is something, you wanna give it to me, give it to me. I'll take it. I'm involved with charter schools to help bring more choices to more students across the nation. I'm involved so that children can enjoy the same benefits that mine do. That's why I'm working with my friend to open SLAM. A charter school in Miami, in the inner city where I grew up. I've had the chance to live all over Miami. Good neighborhoods, bad neighborhoods, the worst neighborhoods. They want to label it the inner city. I relate to it, I understand it, and it taught me almost everything that I know and allowed me to adapt to any environment. Like I say in another one of my songs, if you don't know where you're from, then you don't know where you're going. Well, I come from all kinds of, like I was saying, neighborhoods. I bounced from school to school. As my mom moved from house to house, my mom was my best teacher, and I still learn from her every day. Some things I like, some things I don't. But she did struggle so I could attend better and safer schools where I want better schools for the kids who live where I grew up. I don't want any mom in America to have to lie about where she lives so that her child can attend a better school. And that I agree with 150%. And that's where we're going. We're going to one of my old neighborhoods, Little Havana, we call it La Pequeña Habana, where I came from to help bring better schools to those kids so that they're motivated, so that they're inspired, so that they see somebody that they can relate to, somebody that speaks their language, and somebody that tells them that they can do it, like Miss Ryan did, like Miss Martinez did for me. SLAM is Sports Leadership and Management. It's a charter school that we're gonna open up so that the kids are engaged, they're entertained, more than anything, they're educated through things that they love to do. Doesn't necessarily mean you have to be an athlete, no. But if you love sports one way or another, you can be a broadcaster, an attorney, a therapist. But you're learning in the field that you love. Like I go back to, I wish that I would have grew up and had a chance to be educated like this. So with that said, they were telling me that there's three R's: rigor, relevance, and relationship. Well, that's the motto. So on the plane on the way over here, by the way, I got in at about 5 a.m. from Milwaukee. So we got a lot of Milwaukee folks in here. Well, it was a great show, great energy, great people. Thank you very much. And I said, man, why don't we come up with the three E's, which is engage, entertain, and educate. More than 2,000 students have already applied for 800 slots. Here goes another one. I guess we're gonna need a bigger boat. Or like Cubans would say, tremenda balsa. And in that case, we'll just have to build one. And that's just one small example on how charter schools are energizing and revolutionizing education in America. When I visit students, I tell them, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. Fortunately, we stand together for something that is profoundly motivating. We stand together for great public schools that are independently run and are devoted to the welfare of their students. We won't stand for anything less. The best possible schools, other than the best possible schools for our children. And you're already making that happen. Because the kids who need it the most are the ones benefiting the most from our charter schools. They are the children of families struggling to make ends meet. They are the children who have all the potential in the world, but don't have all the support they need to succeed. Which, by the way, when we were writing this, I said, all the potential in the world that can potentially change the world, and they need all the support that they can possibly get. I go back to this, I'm a prime example of it. They are the children that deserve the right to have a choice that includes receiving the best education possible regardless of their economical situation at home. They are the children that make the American dream a reality. You're looking at one.
Okay.
Making something from nothing is what I've done not only with music. I mean, I came into the music business in the hip hop culture. And as you see, being a Miami boy, one strike at the time, being a Cuban boy, two strikes, being white with blue eyes, that makes it four strikes. Okay, but we fought and we made something from nothing. Not only have we done it with music, done it with my life, gracias a Dios, thank God for that. And now we're doing it with schools and we're doing it with education. When I visit students, I also tell them that the greatest risk they take is not taking one. Which, by the way, Miss Martinez taught me that. And I use it to this day. Anytime I feel that, I feel nervous, like I feel right now, I take the risk. And for all the students, for all the teachers, and for all the educators here, we have to take risk. If we don't take that risk, I go back to it, it's the biggest risk that we take. By doing that, you are changing the course of public education in America and improving our future. That's why I truly believe that education is the real, I go back to it, real revolution. That's why I believe that we are the real revolutionaries, and that's why I'm proud to be a part of this revolution with you. A revolution is successful when people realize there's no going back. Charter schools are here to stay, and they're revolutionizing education in America. There's no going back now. With that said, it's Mr. 305, better said Mr. Worldwide, checking in, checking out. God bless. Thank you so much for having me today. I highly appreciate it. And to everybody in the room, we've done something together today for the first time. This is my first major speech. Muchas gracias.